The craft of Schiffli embroidery is practiced all over the world and involves a vast number of techniques, stitches, threads, base fabrics, and embellishments. With industrialization, the versatility and precision of the Schiffli machine has given it an important role in the textile industry for over 150 years. Schiffli machines are specialized for lace work. They can now be over 30 meters long, equipped with 2,000 or more needles. Some machine manufacturers now prefer to build single needle row machines, usually facing each other so that one operator can handle both at the same time. With the introduction of electromechanical machines, jacquard punch cards or paper tapes were used to encode design data. The preparation of the card was known as punching. This has since given way to computer numerical control, or CNC machines, and the art of embroidery digitizing. This video introduces Schiffli embroidery and the creation of these intricate designs in Wilcom's Embroidery Studio. There are many styles of Schiffli embroidery, but there are two basic types, all over and freestanding. All over embroidery involves continuous stitching on a base fabric, which remains in the final product. Freestanding embroidery employs a water-soluble base material or sacrificial fabric, which is later dissolved, leaving only embroidered stitching in the final product. Sometimes a chemical bath is used to produce what is known as chemical lace. Some machines have borer knives to create small perforations, commonly known as eyelets, in the backing fabric. Historically, needle spacing or rapport was measured as 1 French inch, 1.08 of the English inch, usually 27.07 millimeters. Standard spacing was known as 4-4 rapport. With larger designs, needles can be selectively disengaged, thereby increasing needle spacing to 2, 3, 4 and more French inches. Thus, needle spacing determines design size. Design repeats are known as 4-4, 8-4, 12-4, 16-4 rapport, and so on. The repeat must be accurately designed so that both sides join seamlessly. Schiffli designs generally have fewer and longer, carefully placed stitches. With Schiffli work, practically every stitch is counted. Design quality and productivity is the highest priority. The Schiffli digitizer needs to pay close attention to design repeats, start and end jumps, tension and speed changes, and borer operations. Specific machine knowledge is essential. Some machines have a single thread cut solution, but generally there is no trim device on Schiffli machines. The digitizer must take account of thread hanging off the fabric. For Schiffli work in Embroidery Studio, you first select the Schiffli template. This sets the machine format to Schiffli and turns off automatic connectors. Schiffli objects need to be connected by manually digitized travel stitches or manual trims. The Schiffli template also turns off automatic start and end points and auto fabrics. Schiffli digitizers need to control their own start and end points as well as stitch settings. Customizable settings are common to all Schiffli machines. Digitizers can adjust them to suit their machine characteristics. For instance, if the maximum stitch length supported by your machine is 12 millimeters, you define a custom Schiffli machine format and adjust the value accordingly. Minimum stitch length may be increased for dense materials, thick threads, and older machines in order to prevent thread breakage or inaccurate stitching. While some machines with trimmers recognize specific trim codes, most interpret them as jumps. Set the required number as part of the machine format. Different machines use slightly different needle spacings, a result of slight variations of the French inch. For example, 20.04 mm for Sara, 27.07 mm for Plauen and Zangs, 27.08 mm for Hiraoka. This is an important value. When designing for freestanding embroidery, design repeats must link up precisely, otherwise the lace will fall apart. If you are changing needle spacing, you should also adjust grid spacing. For instance, you may set this value to 27.07 for Plauen or 27.04 for Sara. While automatic connectors are turned off, the Schiffli design template does not change other stitch settings. Schiffli digitizers generally want to set their own. The first goal is to keep overall stitch count as low as possible. Thus, automatic settings are usually turned off as these create smaller stitches. Relatively few stitch types and effects are used in Schiffli embroidery. You may want to preset run, stipple, satin, jagged satin, and tatami settings. For instance, satin cover stitching may employ fixed spacings of anywhere between 0.5mm and 1.2mm. Runs may be between 3 to 3.5mm. It's a good idea to turn off the small stitch filter or set it to eliminate problem short stitches. Once you've adjusted your machine and any other settings to your requirements, save the template for future use. When working with Schiffli designs, ensure the design repeat is correctly defined. Here we set an 8-4 repeat, which given our Plauen machine format, equates to 54.14 millimeters. When digitizing or checking a design, you can set the number of repeats you want to view. Horizontal distance is automatically calculated from the information already provided. Bitmap or vector artwork can be used as a backdrop for Schiffli digitizing. When you insert artwork, you first make sure it conforms to the repeat and grid parameters you've set up. Schiffli embroidery is continuously stitched across the fabric. So that each repeat is securely linked, stitches must be added on both sides. For freestanding design, the linking technique is crucial. Without it, the whole design can fall apart. An advantage of vector artwork is that you can show repeats and plan your links. In addition, vectors can be converted to embroidery objects. Schiffli digitizers typically make extensive use of connecting runs. These provide a framework for the design and eliminate the need for trims. Crucially, they help tie everything together when the substrate is dissolved. Travel direction also needs to be considered. There is no borer in this design as it's freestanding, so the circle is decorative. After the substrate is removed, it looks like a borer hole but with a cross line of stitches. This also helps tie the lace together. In Show Repeats mode, perform a slow redraw to see how all the links are applied. Schiffli digitizers make extensive use of manually digitized underlays for two reasons. One, it gives them greater control over the underlay form, usually double zigzag. And two, because it allows them to create the overall underlay before cover stitching is applied to each object. If the design style requires open satin stitching, the manual method also allows the digitizer to better integrate underlay with the overall design. Here, we create a single manual underlay and then duplicate it with the mirror merge tools. Sometimes you may include underlay with cover stitch, object by object. Here we use a column A object with a double zigzag auto underlay. Again, we use the mirror merge tools to duplicate objects around the design center. For the outer petals, we create an edge run for the entire shape and use a manual double zigzag underlay. We again use the mirror merge tools to duplicate underlay objects around the center. For the outer petals, we want to create a single turning fill with preset satin cover stitch. An easy way to do this is to first create a single half moon with turning fill. Using mirror merge to duplicate, we merge the objects when prompted. Finally, we add satin borders with the simple offsets tool. you may need to add manual connecting stitches to join the borders. With Schiffli designs, it's important that stitching is loose and doesn't pull or push the fabric. This means thread tension must be right. Larger movements pull more thread and increase tension. If there's too much, the fabric distorts and needles may break. In critical parts of the design, we need to manually insert tension and sometimes speed change codes. This is why you'll always see a pair of blat and step codes used with long stitches. Placement depends on the machine and fabric, but the threshold between step and blat is generally around 2.3 to 2.6 millimeters. Schiffli machine functions can be inserted via the dedicated toolbar or by means of shortcut keys. Machine functions are stored with the corresponding object and updated whenever it's modified. In addition to the blat function, some machines use Fadenleiter for even finer tension adjustment. Speed issues in Schiffli machines, like tension, must be considered. The frame is heavy, so longer stitches and large movements need more time. Changes from needles to borers or sequins also require time. Some machines use further fine speed adjustment, like Saura plus or minus 5 RPM increments. The View menu includes a View by Machine Functions option. Step blat tension changes can be viewed as separate colors. This helps locate digitizing errors quickly. Unless your machine has a trimmer, designs must be digitized without trim and tie-off codes. Travel through the design to see where to adjust entry and exit points or insert connecting stitches. Sometimes it may be necessary to add a manual tie-off. Overshooting is a technique used by Schiffli digitizers to feed more thread from the cone and reduce thread tension. This can be done by means of manual stitches. Schiffli machines have built-in borer knives under the needle line, which can cut holes of varying size in the fabric. For this type of work, a non-sacrificial backing fabric is used. On the Schiffli machine, the borer knife has a depth setting. The depth parameter controls how deep the cut will be. Adjust the depth numbering system and default value as required. Depending on the type of work you are doing, you may choose a single borer depth for the entire design. Or you may vary borer depths for different holes within the same design. The smaller the value, the smaller the borer depth, and hence the smaller the hole. Sometimes you may change borer depth during borer operations. Cuts may be larger in the middle of the hole, but taper off towards the edges or corners. How many borer cuts are needed? Only practice can tell. Modern fabrics with plastic yarn content may require more cuts. Generally, you want smaller cuts, 1.2 to 1.5 millimeters apart. These can be achieved by run lines with fixed spacing or with manual stitches. Pull out the loose fabric with manual or zigzag stitches. The complete effect is achieved when cover stitches using normal or metallic threads are added to the eyelets. On a mechanical Schiffli machine, everything is activated by the rotation of the main shaft. Borer depth moves one notch per rotation. Incremental borer depth adjustments are automatically calculated and added to the machine file. Your designs should always be saved in Wilcom EMB file format, as this preserves design settings, including object properties. When you stitch out, however, you need to output the appropriate machine file, for instance, Plough and T10 format or Saura T15. If a selected machine format does not support a particular function in the design, either automatically or manually inserted, it's ignored. When outputting machine files, you may need to adjust encoding options to stitch correctly on the target machine. Options vary with the selected file type, whether based on Plauen or SARA formats. The production worksheet provides important information for machine operators. Printing a Schiffli production worksheet is like printing for multi-head, with the difference that you can show several repeats in both directions. For more information about digitizing for Schiffli, refer to the latest Embroidery Studio Schiffli supplement.